Have a moody teenager. A lot of people do. Well, those two words go together pretty commonly.
Your teenager could just be being a teen, or they could be dealing with something else. In this morning's STL Mom segment, Fox 2's Molly Rose is talking with a doctor about it.
Yeah, and what we're talking about this morning, Randy and John, seasonal affective disorder. It could be making things tough for your teen. That could be adding to the problem. So we're talking to Dr. Sarah Warwood joining us this morning. She's an adolescent medicine physician at St. Louis Children's Hospital. Doctor, thank you for being with us this morning to talk about this topic.
Good morning. Thank you.
So last week we had bad weather. It wasn't sunny a lot of the days. Kind of the perfect storm for someone who could be suffering with this. Can you talk about what are some of the symptoms parents can look out for?
Sure. So as you mentioned, it's not unusual for teens to have some mood changes or for teens to have impacts on how they feel with the change of the seasons. Many of us experience those winter blahs or winter blues. But the difference is for seasonal affective disorder, someone has really clinical level of symptoms with decrease in their mood, less energy, less motivation. Often with seasonal affective disorder, people have carbohydrate cravings or increase in eating, increase in sleeping in that case, and also can have impacts on their functioning. So ability to concentrate in school, how their grades end up, how they can interact socially with their friends or with their family.
What exactly causes it and how do you treat it? Until warmer weather comes, what can we do?
Right. So it's not fully understood. What we do recognize is that with those change in the seasons, we have changes in mood that seem to then resolve with the next change in season. There are impacts in the brain hormones, there are impacts in serotonin levels in the brain, all related to less light exposure, because that light exposure does impact our mood regulation. In terms of treating it, I always recommend getting back to the basics with your kids, so trying to enforce regular sleep schedules, good sleep hygiene, regular meal times, good nutrition. A big thing is getting outside, getting some sunlight when you can, getting some regular exercise. And if those things don't improve mood, there are some specific treatments for seasonal affective disorder, including use of light boxes. So exposure to early morning light in particular may be helpful. But beyond that, sometimes teens do need professional help. So sometimes they need to speak with a mental health professional for therapy, or they may need to actually talk with their doctors about use of medication to improve the neurotransmitters in the brain.
Great information, Dr. Garwood. Thank you so much for breaking it all down for us. We've got some contact information there on the screen. For more information, you can go to stlouischildrens.org.